Now I'm just going to show you each of the puppies because I had made each one a little bit different. And this one is the original one. And you could see how she has the really pretty green eyes. And I kind of pulled the yarn apart so she had more of a fuzzy appearance. And she has Karen 1 pound yarn that's used for her head. And then the yarn spun or homespun yarn I used on the snout and for the ears. And you can see how it blends really well. And I used the homespun yarn on her feet as well. And then on her body, I just used the Karen 1 pound yarn. And then for the tail, I used the homespun yarn. And you can mix it up. You don't have to use the homespun yarn for everything, but definitely for the pretty hair. And then for the next one, this one, I named this one Rose because of her pretty eyes. And then she has the purple hair ribbons. And I actually used a plastic nose for her so you can see what that looks like. And this is just a red heart yarn. And this color is medium purple. And I used the Karen 1 pound on her feet and then just put little toenails on her. And I show how to do that in the video. And for her hair, I didn't take apart the yarn strands so you could see the curls more in hers. So it's a preference on what you want your dog to look like. And then this is what she looks like from behind. And I used the Karen 1 pound for her tail. And for this one, I played around with this beautiful yarn. It's driftwood. And this one's from Country Loom, Loops and Threads. And you can see her beautiful eyes, named her Peaches because of her orange in her eyes. And she has a yarn nose. And for her, I mixed up the homespun yarn with the Country Loom driftwood color. And it came out really pretty. And she also has, this is a red heart yarn. And I find that the red heart yarn is really close in color. It's the buffalo color. But it's not as sturdy, I should say, as the Karen 1 pound yarn. So there's subtle differences, but not much. I actually prefer the red heart Super Saver one. So that's what she looks like. And this one, I made her ear completely with the Country Loom driftwood color and also her feet. So you can see what a difference it makes. And also, I show in the video how to do little eyelashes. And I prefer the eyelashes with this color. For some reason, it looks better than I do with this one. So it's just a preference on what you, for your dog, what you want to do. But I just wanted to show you what they each look like up close. So you can see her feet. And then on the back, I did her body also in the driftwood. And those are the puppies. So you're going to need your G or 4 millimeter crochet hook for this project. And you're also going to need a pair of scissors and a tapestry needle, and I used a sharp-ended tapestry needle. And these are the animal noses that I used, and I used a size of 21 millimeters. So there are different eyes that you can use for your puppies, and you can use the solid black eyes, and I used the 9 millimeter. And here you can see what the solid black eye looks like on the puppy. Or you can use the sun catcher eyes. And you can see this is the one that I used on one of the puppies. And this is the one that I'm using for the one that I'm making right now. And these are 9 millimeter sun catcher eyes. And this is what the packaging looks like. And again, I'm using the 9mm. And I'm using these little purple designs by Ofray. Little accessories. They have all kinds of different other ones too that you can pick from. And to sew them on, you're going to need a regular sewing needle and some thread. The first thing we're going to make is the snout. So you're going to take the homespun yarn and just drape it across your four fingers. Use your thumb to stabilize, and then drape the yarn around your two middle fingers twice, and then hold it in place with your pinky and thumb. Then you're going to take your G crochet hook or 4mm crochet hook and go under those two loops. And then you're going to yarn over, bring up a loop, and then yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and then go through that loop for a slip knot. And now you're going to do 6 single crochet into the magic circle. So you just go under those two loops, bring up a loop, you have 2 loops on the hook, yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through both loops for a single crochet. And then you're going to do 6 single crochet into the magic circle. And then you're going to take your forefinger and thumb and then just hold it at the base of those 6 single crochet. And then you have the 2 loops on the other side. You're going to grab one of these loops and pull on it to see if it'll close your magic circle. If it doesn't close, you let go and pull on the other one. But this one's closing, so I'm going to just close it loosely. You don't have to pull it too tight right now because we can close it more later. Then take your loose yarn in and pull on that loosely. And now you're going to do 2 single crochet into every stitch around. So you're going to go into that first stitch. You're going to bring up a loop, 2 loops on the hook, yarn over, turn the hook upside down and go through both for a single crochet. Go into the same stitch and then do another single crochet. And you're going to do 2 single crochet into every stitch around until you have a total of 12. Okay, then I have 2 more. Now I'll make 12. And this is how your work should look. And you could turn your work over now if you have a little hole in the center of your magic circle that you want to completely close. Just turn your work over and pull on that loose yarn in snugly. And then that should close up the center of the magic circle. Now you're going to need a yarn marker, and I'm just going to use one of my scraps of yarn. Just place it right where you left off because we're going to do an increase round. So now you're going to do 1 single crochet into the first stitch, and then 2 single crochet into the second stitch, and you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. So in the next stitch, it's just 1 single crochet, and then in the second stitch, 2 single crochet, and you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around until you're back to the yarn marker. So I'm just going to go ahead and finish up with you. 1 single crochet, 2 single crochet in the same stitch, 1 single crochet, Two. And now I'm back to my yarn marker. So you can go ahead and take your yarn marker and move it up. And we're going to get ready for the next round. Now you're going to do one single crochet into every stitch. So one single crochet into every stitch. And you're going to do that for two rows. And then come back. So finish one single crochet into every stitch for two rounds and then come back. All right, so you should have finished two rounds of one single crochet into every stitch. You can go ahead and remove your yarn marker. And this is the wrong side, the side that you have your loose yarn end sticking out. So you're going to turn it so that the right side is showing. And now we're just going to go ahead and do a slip stitch into the next stitch. So you take your crochet hook, go into the next stitch, and you're going to yarn over, and you're going to pull the yarn through both loops on your hook for a slip stitch. And then you're going to finish off, you're going to yarn over and pull your yarn through, and you can pull enough yarn to sew it onto the head. And then just cut it. And then just pull it snug. And now you're going to need your black yarn because we're going to draw the nose and the mouth on. Now you're going to get your black yarn and put it onto your tapestry needle. And I'm using Soft Secret Yarn Bee Black, but you can use any black yarn that you want. Red Heart Super Saver works well also. And then you just take and you go from the wrong side, and you're going to come up through the wrong side to the right side. But I just wanted to show you, here's the center of the magic circle, and we're going to completely cover this circle pattern here with the black yarn. So you're going to come up from the inside, and you can see where I'm coming up with my tapestry needle along that circle. And make sure that you leave enough yarn on the inside to tie a knot. And then we're just going to follow the pattern of the circle with our black yarn. So you can see how I'm making the circle for the nose. And then you're going to take and completely cover the center part of the nose. So you can come up along the inside of the circle you created and just go down. And you're just going to keep doing this until the whole nose is completely covered. And then come back. Now, once you have the center completely covered, then you're going to draw the smile on the nose, on the underneath the nose. So you're going to come up with your tapestry needle at the base of the nose, and then just go down one row, and then you're going to come up and then back down to form half of the smile. And then you're going to go up equally on the other side. Make sure you're equal with the other side of the smile with your tapestry needle. And now you can tie your knot on the inside and then cut your loose yarn end And then come back and I'll show you how to do the tongue. Now you're just going to get your pink yarn on your tapestry needle. And I'm just using any pink yarn. This is like a Red Heart Super Saver type of yarn, or Karen 1 pound yarn. And I'm just going to take that pink yarn and I'm going to come in from the wrong side, right where I want the tongue, the center of the mouth. And make sure you leave, again, enough yarn on the inside for tying a knot. And then you're just going to go right back in towards the wrong side again. And make sure that you leave a little bit of a loop, however big you want the tongue to be. And then you're just going to take and tie a knot on the inside. And you can even kind of take a little bit of the inside yarn and tie a knot. Make sure it doesn't go through to the right side. And then just tie your knot again, just to make sure it doesn't come out. Make sure it's nice and tight and secure. And make sure that when you're tying this knot that you don't pull the loop loose that you created for the tongue. And so here you can see the little tongue that's on the outside, and then you have a well tied knot on the inside so it doesn't come undone. Now you can use your tan colored yarn, whatever color yarn that you have that closely matches your homespun yarn that you're using. And this color is lace and is from Karen 1 pound. And we're going to make the head. So we're going to do the magic circle again. And we're going to do 6 single crochet. So the first thing we're going to do is bring up a loop, yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through that loop for your slip knot. And now you're going to do 6 single crochet into the magic circle. There's one. I'm going to do this slowly if you're not used to doing the magic circle. And then I'm going to take my forefinger and thumb and just hold it at the base of the 6 single crochet. And then I'm going to close the magic circle just like I did before. And now you're going to do 2 single crochet into every stitch around until you have a total 12, just like we did before. So 2 single crochet into every stitch all the way around until you have a total of 12, and then come back. So now we're going to do the increase rounds. So I'm taking my yarn marker and just place it right where you left off. And now you're going to do 1 single crochet into the first stitch, and then 2 single crochet into the second stitch. And you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker, and then come back. Okay, so now we're going to do another increase round. Go ahead and move your yarn marker up. And now you're going to do 1 single crochet into 2 stitches, and then 2 single crochet into the third stitch. And you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. Now this is going to be our last increase round. Go ahead and take your yarn marker and move it up. And now you're going to do 1 single crochet into 3 stitches. And then you're going to do 2 single crochet into the fourth stitch. And repeat that pattern all the way back around. Go ahead and move your yarn marker up. And now you're going to do 1 single crochet into every stitch around, and you're going to do that for 8 rounds. So go ahead and complete one single crochet into every stitch for 8 rounds, and then come back. Now you should have finished 8 rows of one single crochet into every stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And now you're just going to leave a little bit of a loop because you're going to sew the snout on. So just turn it to the other side so you can sew the snout on. And so I showed you how to make the snout, but I want to show you an alternative where you just use an animal nose. If you're using the plastic nose instead, this is how I placed it. And you can see that right at the tip of the nose is the center of the magic circle. And then the mouth is made the same way. And then what's nice about these noses is they have these little nice safety latches on the back, so they're not going to come out. And you could take any loose yarn ends and tuck them to the inside and go ahead and get a little bit of stuffing to help shape the nose or the snout. Then go ahead and get your tapestry needle and put it on the long end that you left for sewing. If you didn't leave a very long end for sewing, then just get the same colored yarn to sew on the snout. And then you're going to take and place the snout right along the edge, the bottom edge of this of the head. Make sure that your nose is straight, and you can turn your work. And then you're just going to sew the bottom portion of the snout to the head. And you're just going to go in and out and just sew all the way around, keeping the nose straight and tucking the snout as you sew it on. So I'm going to go ahead and sew mine on, and then I'll come back and show you how it looks on the head. So here's my snout, and I've already sewed it on, and you can see how many rows I had. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the top of the 6th row, and then down from the center of the magic circle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now we're going to place the eyes. So now this is how I placed my eyes, and you can see how far I am from the snout, and then in between each eye there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So if you want to place them exactly the same, that's how I placed my eyes. And then on the inside you can see how they have the safety latches so they won't come out. If you like the eyelashes, I used Yarn Bee Soft Secret Black yarn, and I just took it on my tapestry needle. And this is what the dog looks like without the eyelash. And this is what the dog looks like with the eyelash. So you can decide if you want to have an eyelash or not. But if you do, then you're just going to take your tapestry needle and you're going to come in from the inside right next to the eye with the tapestry needle, and make sure you leave enough yarn on the inside for tying your knot. And then you're going to go up however long you want your lashes. See, I'm going to go a little bit lower. And then I'm going to come back up through the same opening that I started with. And then I'm going to go down. And then you're going to do the same thing on the other side. So this is just a close-up of the eyelashes that I just put. So you can just see how they're placed. Now, after you finish sewing everything in place, we're going to start our decrease round. So go ahead and take your yarn marker and move it up. And then you're going to do one single crochet into the next stitch. And then do your decrease stitch. And you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. So I'm going to show you one more. Go into the next stitch. You're going to do one single crochet. And then you're going to do your decrease stitch. So you're going to go into the next stitch, bring up a loop. You have two loops on the hook. Go into the next stitch, bring up a loop. Three loops on the hook. Yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through all three loops for a decrease stitch. Go ahead and repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. Okay, so you should be back at your yarn marker. Go ahead and move it up. And we're going to repeat the same pattern back around to the yarn marker. So one single crochet into the next stitch, and then you're going to do your decrease stitch. So go ahead and repeat that pattern all the way around back to your yarn marker. This is how your work should be looking. And now I'm almost back to the yarn marker. I have two stitches left. I'm just going to go ahead and do a single crochet into each of those last stitches. And now you're going to do a slip stitch into the next stitch. You can take your yarn marker and remove that. So take your crochet hook, go into that next stitch, yarn over, and then bring the yarn through both loops on your hook for a slip stitch. And then you're going to go ahead and finish off. Yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and bring enough yarn through to bury into your work. And now we're going to make the ear. Now you're going to use your yarn, whatever yarn that you're using for your ear. And if you're making this type of dog, then you're going to want this colored homespun yarn. And if you want the same kind as Azul's, then I used Country Loom, Loops and Thread, and the color. Let's see. Driftwood is the color. Now, to make the ear, we're going to do the magic circle. So, you're going to drape the yarn across your four fingers and use your thumb to stabilize. And then you're going to wrap the yarn around your two middle fingers twice. And then hold it in place with your pinky and your thumb. Then you're going to take your crochet hook, and I'm using my G crochet hook. Go under those two loops around the middle finger. I'm going to yarn over and bring up a loop. Then you're going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through that loop for a slip knot. And now you're going to do six single crochet into the magic circle. So you're going to go under those two loops, bring up a loop. You have two loops on your hook, yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through both for a single crochet. And you're going to do that six times. And try not to make your single crochets too tight, because then it's hard for you to get in to those stitches. And here is where you can kind of loosen it up a little bit. Just lift up. See how I'm making a bigger loop? And again, I can lift up a little bit. Allow a little bit of slack, not too loose. Now, just take your forefinger and your thumb and go to the base of those six single crochet, and then you have two loops on the opposite side of your magic circle. You're going to pull on one of them. If it doesn't close, let go and then pull on the other loop. But this one's closing, so I'm just going to close it gently, because you can always close it more later. So just loosely close it can see how much I've closed mine. Then take your loose yarn in and pull on that loosely. Don't worry if you still have a little bit of a hole there because we can close it more later. And now what you're going to do is you're going to take your crochet hook into that first stitch under both loops. And then you're going to bring up a loop. You have two loops on your hook. Yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through both for a single crochet. And you're going to do two single crochet into the same stitch. And then you're going to do two single crochet into every stitch all the way around until you finished 12, a total of 12. So go ahead, finish doing two single crochet into every stitch all the way around until you have a total of 12.
And then come
this
back.
Is how your work should look. And if you still have a little bit of an opening at the center of your magic circle, you can turn your work over and pull on that loose yarn end snugly. And then that closes up the magic circle. And now we're going to do an increase round. Go ahead and take your yarn marker and place it right where you left off. And I just use a scrap yarn for my yarn marker. But you can use one of the regular ones if you want to. Now, for the increase round, you're going to go into that first stitch, bring up a loop, two loops on the hook, yarn over and go through both for a single crochet. And then in the second stitch, you're going to do two single crochet into the same stitch. And then you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. And then come back. When you're back to the yarn marker, go ahead and take it and move it up to where you left off. And now you're going to do one single crochet into every stitch. And you're going to do that for 10 rounds. So go ahead and complete 10 rounds of one single crochet into every stitch around. And then come back. Okay, so now I finished one single crochet in every stitch. For 10 rows, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And now you're going to do a slip stitch into the next stitch over. So go into the next stitch, yarn over, and bring the yarn through both loops on your hook for a slip stitch. Then you're going to finish off. You're going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through that loop. And bring enough yarn through to sew the ear onto the dog. And then you can just pull the yarn snugly and take out your yarn marker. And you're going to need two of these. Now you're going to take your ear and you're going to take the long end that you left for sewing and put your tapestry needle on it. And my tapestry needle, as you can see, has a pointy end to it. And if you don't have a real long end for sewing, you can just take the same colored yarn to sew it on. And the first thing I do is just line up the ear where I want it. And then once I have it lined up, I'm going to take my tapestry needle and sew so that the needle comes up towards the top of the head. So you can see how I went in with my tapestry needle, and then I'm coming out on the head where I want the tip of the ear to be. And then I'm just bringing, hold the ear in place, and then I'm just going to bring my tapestry needle through. And then I'm going to take and go into the ear at the corner. And that way I have the first part done for the ear. Now that I've done that corner, now I'm going to place the ear. So here you can see how many stitches that I am away from the snout, which is about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 stitches away. And then I'm going to take and just sew along the inner part of the ear. just going in and out. You can sew it down better later. This is just to help secure the ear where you want it first. And then just go down towards the corner that you want the bottom part of the ear. And then you can take and hook that bottom part of the ear. And that way you have it sewn in place. And then you can start sewing the ear on better and making sure that it's more secure. And then just make sure that your ears are equal. And then finish sewing both ears on. Now with this ear, I'm finding that my yarn is getting a little short. So if that happens, what I do is I go towards the back of the ear and then I'm just going to tie a knot. And since I'm using this type of yarn to make the loops on the ear, you can take this same yarn, if you're finding that you need to do the same thing, and just come out around this level, about 1, 2, 3 rows down, because we can use this yarn as part of the long yarn ends that we're using for the ear. So you can just leave that there and then just get a new yarn to finish sewing the ear on. And then also, just wanted to let you know that I stuffed the head, before I started sewing the ears on. And that just helps to keep the head nice and round. And I just used old pillow stuffing. And I usually get my pillows from Walmart because I can get them for under $3 for a large pillow. And you can stuff a lot of animals with those. Now for the body, I'm back to my Karen 1 pound lace colored yarn. And we're going to do a magic circle again. So you just use your thumb to stabilize and then wrap the yarn around your two middle fingers and then hold it in place with your pinky and your thumb. And then we're going to do the slip knot. So go ahead and bring up a loop, yarn over, turn the hook upside down and go through that loop for your slip knot. And then you're going to do 6 single crochet into the magic circle. And then again, you're just going to take the base, hold magic circle at the base, and close the magic circle. And then you're going to do 2 single crochet into every stitch around until you have a total of 12. And then come back. And at this point, you can close your magic circle if you need to before we start doing our increase rounds. And go ahead and get your yarn marker and place it right where you left off. And then you're going to do 1 single crochet into the first stitch and then 2 single crochet into the second stitch. And then you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker and then come back. For the next increase round, take your yarn marker and move it up, and you're going to do 1 single crochet into the next 2 stitches, and then 2 single crochet into the third stitch. And then repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. And now for the last increase round, you're going to do 1 single crochet into the next 3 stitches, the first 3 stitches. And then in the fourth stitch, you do 2 single crochet into the same stitch. And then repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. Now go ahead and take your yarn marker and move it up. And now we're going to do 1 single crochet into every stitch around. And you're going to do that for 5 rounds. So after you complete 5 rounds, of one single crochet into every stitch. Come back, and then I'll show you what to do next. After you finish your five rounds, one, two, three, four, five, of one single crochet into every stitch, go ahead and take your yarn marker and move it up. And now we're going to start doing our decrease rounds. So you're going to do one single crochet into the first stitch, and one single crochet into the second stitch, and then you're going to do your decrease stitch. So you go into the next stitch, bring up a loop, go into the next stitch, bring up a loop, three loops on the hook, yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through all three for a decrease. And you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. Now I have two stitches left before the yarn marker. I'm going to just do a single crochet into each of those last two stitches. And then I'm just going to take and move my yarn marker up. And we're going to do another decrease round. This time you're going to do one single crochet into one stitch. And then you're going to do your decrease stitch. And then you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. And again, I have two stitches left. So I'm just going to do one single crochet into each of those stitches. Move up your yarn marker. And now you're just going to do one single crochet into every stitch around. And you're going to do that for two rounds. So one single crochet into every stitch and do that for two rounds. And then come back. Now I just finished two rounds of one single crochet into every stitch around. Now you're going to go ahead and do a slip stitch. So go into the next stitch with your crochet hook and yarn over and bring the yarn through both loops on your hook. And then you're going to finish off. You're going to yarn over, turn the hook side down, and then just bring enough yarn through to bury into your work. And now the body is finished. And I'm just going to show you how to do the front legs and the back legs. Okay, so now we're going to make the front leg. So we're going to do a magic circle. Just drape your yarn across your four fingers. Use your thumb to stabilize. And then wrap the yarn around your two middle fingers. And then hold it in place with your pinky and your thumb. And again, we're going to do the slip knot. And then six single crochet into the magic circle. And then just hold it at the base with your forefinger and thumb. And then you're just going to close the magic circle. Now just do two single crochet into every stitch until you've finished a total of 12. I'll do the first one with you. So one single crochet and then two single crochet in the same stitch. And you're going to do two single crochet into every stitch around until you have a total of 12. Now just get your yarn marker and put it right where you left off. And we're going to do an increase round. You're going to do one single crochet into the next stitch. And then two single crochet into the second stitch. And then you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. Now go ahead and move your yarn marker up. And you're just going to do one round of one single crochet into every stitch. So go ahead and do one single crochet into every stitch all the way around back to the yarn marker. Go ahead and take your yarn marker and move it up. And now I just want to show you a close-up. So here you can see your stitch, and we're going to work with the crochet hook down the center of the stitch, and we're going to grab that back loop only with our crochet hook. So you can see that here you have the back loop, and then here you have the front loop, and we're going to be working in the back loop only. So take your crochet hook, you're going to go right down the center, you're going to go into that back loop only. I'm going to bring up a loop, two loops on the hook, yarn over and go through both for a single crochet, and you're going to do one single crochet into the back loop only for eight stitches. So I just did 4. Six, seven, and 8. Now you're going to do a single crochet, go under both loops, bring up a loop, yarn over, and go through both for a single crochet. So go ahead and finish doing your single crochets all the way back to the yarn marker, and then come back. Now go ahead and take your yarn marker and move it up. And you're just going to do one round of one single crochet into every stitch. So go ahead and do one single crochet into every stitch all the way around back to the yarn marker. Okay, so now you're going to go ahead and take your yarn marker. And we're going to do a decrease round. So you're going to do one single crochet into the first stitch. And then you're going to do a decrease stitch. So you're going to go into the next stitch, bring up a loop, go into the next stitch, and bring up a loop. You have 3 loops on the hook. Yarn over and go through all 3 for a decrease stitch. So one stitch, single crochet, and then the next one is a decrease stitch. And you're going to do that all the way around back to the yarn marker and then come back. Your work should be looking like this. And now we're going to do rounds of just one single crochet into every stitch. So go ahead and do one single crochet into every stitch for 7 rounds and then come back. So 7 rounds of one single crochet every stitch. You should have finished 7 rows of one single crochet into every stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now we're going to do a slip stitch. Take your crochet hook, go into the next stitch over, yarn over, and bring the yarn through both loops on your hook for a slip stitch, then yarn over, and we're going to finish off. Just bring enough yarn through to sew the foot onto the body. So for this one, you're going to need 2 of these. So now I'm going to show you how to do the hind legs. So this is the front leg. And you need 2 of them, and then I'm going to show you the hind leg. All right, so now to make the hind leg, you're going to start the same way with a magic circle. And we're going to do 6 single crochet into the magic circle, just like we did for the front leg. And you just close up your magic circle just like you did before. And you're going to do 2 single crochet into every stitch around, just like you did for the front leg. So go ahead, finish doing 2 single crochet into every stitch around until you have a total of 12, and then come back. Go ahead and get your yarn marker and just place it right where you left off. And we're going to do an increase round. Go ahead and just do 1 single crochet into the first stitch, and then 2 single crochet into the second stitch, and then repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. Okay, now we're going to do 1 single crochet into every stitch all the way around. So just 1 round of 1 single crochet into every stitch. And again, go ahead and take your yarn marker up. And this time, we're going to do a decrease round. You're actually going to do 2 rounds exactly the same way. So you're going to do 1 single crochet into 1 stitch. And then you're going to do a decrease stitch. So you're going to go into the next stitch, bring up a loop, 2 loops on the hook, go into the next stitch, bring up a loop, 3 loops on the hook, yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through all 3 for a decrease. So I'm going to do 1 more set with you. You're just going to repeat this pattern all the way around to the yarn marker, and you're going to do that for 2 rounds. So you're going to do 1 single crochet into the first stitch, And then you're going to do your decrease stitch. And you're going to do the same thing for the second round. One single crochet in the first stitch, and then your decrease stitch. Do that for two rounds. This is how your work should look. Go ahead and take your yarn marker and move it up. And now you're going to do one single crochet into every stitch around. And you're going to do that for four rows and then come back. So one single crochet into every stitch for four rounds. After you finish your four rounds, one, two, three, four, of one single crochet into every stitch, go ahead and stuff the hind leg because we're going to close it. And now you can go ahead and take out your yarn marker. You're not going to need it because we're going to slip stitch it closed. And how you're going to do that is you're going to skip a stitch and then go into the next stitch over. And then you're going to yarn over and bring the yarn through both loops on your hook for a slip stitch. And then you're going to skip a stitch. And you're just going to do that, slip stitch it until it's closed. And it looks like it's closed up nicely. So now I'm going to finish off. Just going to yarn over and just pull enough yarn through to bury into your work. And you can go ahead and get rid of your loose yarn end. Taking your tapestry needle, just taking the loose yarn end. And then just go right through the center, come out anywhere. And then just cut your loose yarn in. And then your hind leg is done. Go ahead and do one more hind leg. Now you're going to get your two front legs. And you're going to take your tapestry needle. And just put the tapestry needle on the long end that you left for sewing. And if you didn't leave that long of a end for sewing, then just get the same colored yarn. And then you can kind of squish. Make sure that the design that you have for the front paw is facing forward. And then just squeeze the top flat and make sure you stuff it. Then take the body and you're going to sew the leg onto the body. So just line up the rim of the top of the body and then the top of the front foot and take your tapestry needle and just sew the front foot to the body. So you're just going in and out of the top stitches of both the body and the front leg and making sure that you sew it in place. Make sure you get all the stitches of the leg and the body. And then once you're done, you're going to take and do the same thing for the other foot. Front foot, flatten it, and then just sew it right next to the other foot and sew it on the same way and then come back. So this is what your work should look like right now, and you have your two front feet sewn on. Now you want to go ahead and get some yarn onto your tapestry needle because we're going to sew the head on. Now you should have your yarn on your tapestry needle. And I usually start sewing the head on in between the legs and then just take, because you want to line up your nose, make sure your nose is straight right between the legs. And you're going to go ahead and take your tapestry needle and you're going to hook the stitch on the head, right below the nose. Make sure you leave enough yarn for tying a knot and burying into your work. And the whole time that you're sewing the head in place, you want to make sure that you're keeping the nose straight. And then you just take your tapestry needle and you're just going to go in and out. And you can, it's okay if you turn the head at first because we're getting started sewing. And then you can always do more stitches to make sure the head is secure the second time that you make your round. So go ahead and sew the head onto the body, making sure that you keep the nose straight or pointing down between the legs, and then come back. So now your work should look like this, and you can see how I have the head sewed on. Looks good. So now go ahead and get your hind legs, and you're also going to need your tapestry needle with some same colored yarn on it, and you're going to line up the hind legs where you have the large, kind of like a drumstick, looks like a drumstick. Well, the larger end is facing the back, and you're just going to line it up on the dog. Make sure that your dog can sit, and then you're going to squeeze together the pieces just like this, and then you're going to take your tapestry needle. You can hold your dog however is easiest for you to maneuver, and you're just going to take your tapestry needle, and I'm going in about couple stitches, a couple rows down. You can see where I'm going in, and I'm going to go through the body and out the other side, and you can kind of aim it to where you're coming out about the same area and pull it through. If you have something that you can grip, like a little plastic that you use, those jar openers, those work good too to grip the needle. Sometimes that helps to bring it through, but leave enough yarn to tie a knot. And then you're just going to go about a stitch over, and then you're going to go back across, and you're going to come out about a stitch over on the other side. So you can see I'm coming out about a stitch down below. See if I can, there you can see my tapestry needles right there. So I'm just going to pull on that. This is where that jar opener can sometimes help grip the tapestry needle. And then once you've come through, you can just kind of let loose. Let the body open up a little bit. And then once you've done that, you just take and tie a knot. And then you just cut your, you can do a second time if you want. But I'm going to go ahead and just cut my loose yarn end now. Now you're going to bury both your loose yarn ends. Just take your tapestry needle, and you're going to go in right about where you tied your knot, and you can come out anywhere. Go ahead and bury both yarn ends and then come back, and then I'm going to show you how to tie the hind leg to the front leg. So now you're going to get your tapestry needle with some yarn on it, and I've already attached this front leg to this hind leg, and now you're just going to line up, see about where that hind leg will sit onto the front leg, and then you're going to take and put your tapestry needle through the front leg, the back of the front leg, and make sure you leave enough yarn end that you can very easily. And then you're going to take and go back across the hind leg. And then you're just going to take and tie a knot. And then now you have the hind leg attached to the front leg, and you could bring the feet together also if you want. But mine's staying up pretty good just like this, so I'm just going to leave my dog just like that. So I'm going to go ahead and bury my loose yarn ends. So you just take and bring your loose yarn end right where you tied your knot and bring it through the front anywhere. And then just cut your loose yarn ends and then come back. Now you could either leave the front paws like this, or you can do the painted toenails. So I'm going to show you how to do that. You're just going to take your whatever color you want for the toenails and put the yarn onto your tapestry needle. And then you're going to go into the foot. And up with the tapestry needle, right on the far side of the paw where you want the toenail. And make sure you leave enough loose yarn end so you can bury the loose yarn end easily. And then you're going to take your tapestry needle, go back in where you first started. And then you're going to go about 2 stitches over, just like this, with your tapestry needle. And you can see how you have one side made. Now you're going to go straight down for the second toenail, and you're going to come out 2 stitches over. So your tapestry needle looks like that. So we've already made one. So now we're going to make the second one, and at the same time, we're going to make the last one. So you can see how I made the second one. So now you're going to go straight down and across to where you first went in. So you're going to go just like that. And then you have your painted toenails. You're going to do the same thing on the other side. And now you just have to make sure you tie your knot. Then you're just going to take your tapestry needle. You're going to go right in where you tied your knot and come out anywhere on the back. And that's how you're going to bury your loose yarn ends. Go ahead and bury your other loose yarn end. And then go ahead and make the other painted toenail if that's what you want. Now for the fun part, you're going to do the hair, and you're going to get your whatever color yarn that you're using for the hair and put that onto your tapestry needle. Now, once you have the yarn on your tapestry needle, we're going to start doing the hair. And I'm going to start, here's the magic circle here, and there's 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to start on the 5th row up, and I'm just going to start on the edge. And you can see that I'm just grabbing about a stitch of the ear. And just the front part of the ear. And then you're just going to leave. Don't worry if you have, I'm leaving about this much below the ear. And don't worry, we can always trim it more later. So that's about how much I'm leaving. And then I'm going to take and loop right next to where I went in, I'm going to loop the yarn. And make sure that the looped yarn is the same length as that first yarn end that you left. And you're just going to keep going along that row and looping your yarn until you run out. Just making sure that your looped yarn is the same length all the way across. And then once you start running out of the yarn, just pull that the rest of the yarn through, and the loop is the same length, and this may be a little bit longer, but it's not enough to loop again, so just leave that alone because we can always trim it later. And then what you're going to do is you're going to go back to the beginning and take that first loop that you created, and you're going to take your scissors and cut the end of that loop. And you're going to take that loose yarn end that you had, and you're going to tie a knot. And be careful when you tie this knot that you don't pull your loops or your yarns through, because you don't want to affect the length that you had created. So then you take your second loop that you created, and you just keep tying knots all along. So go ahead and finish tying your knots. And then when you finish, let me just tie this knot and then I'll show you. So you can see how I'm creating the hair on this row. So once you finish tying all of your knots, then you're going to get more yarn on your tapestry needle and just finish this row and then come back, and then I'll show you how to move up and do the next row. Now I'm going to take, I've already finished that row all the way across, so now I'm just going to go a couple of rows up. And then to do the same thing on this row, except I'm going to leave the length of hair now so it matches the bottom of the previous row. So I'm just going to keep looping on this whole row. And I'm making sure that the loop I create is going to be the same length as my loose yarn end. And you're just going to do that all the way across. And if you run out of yarn, which I'm about to run out now, so I'm going to make sure that my loops are all the same size. And if I have a little bit extra length, that's okay. So you're going to do the same thing. You're going to tie your knots and make your loops all the way across on this row and then come back. So you can see how the hair looks on this side. And I would wait to trim the hair until you finish the other side, and then you can trim the hair how you want it. And now I'm just going to show you how to put the hair onto the legs. So on the legs, you're just going to take, and I'm just going to get some more, I'm going to use up my old yarn here, and then I'll show you some fresh yarn. And you're just going to do the same thing. You're going to start at the top of the leg, and you're just going to bring the yarn through. And since this is a short piece of yarn, I'm just going to kind of, see, I don't think it'll loop again. So I'm just going to tie a knot, and then I'm just going to see how long I want the hair to be, and I'm going to go ahead and leave the length of my hair to almost the bottom of the painted toenails. So go ahead and get some more yarn, and then I'll show you how to finish the
So I
front
got some more
leg.
yarn on my tapestry needle, and I'm going to go ahead.
And just pull the yarn through. Make sure that your yarn doesn't get tangled. And then you're going to pull the loose yarn end until it reaches the bottom of the painted toenails. Or if you didn't paint the toenails, then just leave the bottom portion of the foot showing. And you're just going to keep looping the yarn across the top. And make sure that you get all your previous yarn pieces, they don't get tangled. And then you're just going to keep looping the yarn just like you did on the ear. Make sure that all your loops are the same size. And then you're just going to take and tie a knot just like you did on the ear. And you're going to do that for both sides. And you're just going to do it along the top all the way across. So when you finish this side, go ahead and tie off the last piece on this leg and start fresh on this leg. And then come back. So you can see how my work looks. And you could put as much hair or as little hair as you want. And I went all across the top, and then I even went a couple rows down and just put a little bit of hair there too. But if you wanted to put a little bit more hair, you can do that as well. But I like the way it looks with just that amount of hair. And then, of course, I'm going to be doing the same thing on this side. And if you want it to go a little bit further at the bottom, you can do that as well. So you can just kind of make your own unique dog the way that you want. So now you're just going to finish the same on both sides, but before I finish mine, I'm going to show you how to sew on the little designs. Now to sew these on, you're going to take your sewing needle and some white thread, and you're just going to place it where you want it. And then you're going to take and go in through the head in the back and up through the ribbon. And you're just going to make sure you leave enough to tie a knot. So leave enough loose yarn in to tie a knot. And then you're going to go back in. Just take a little, like a little millimeter stitch over from where you came out. You're going to go into the head. And then you're going to come up under one of the other ribbons. That way, no one's going to see the thread. And you can see how it's very hard to see it. You can't even see it. And then you're just going to come up through the little ribbon with your white thread. And you're just going to do that all the way around. And then I'm just going to go back in and come through the head on the other side, underneath one of the other ribbons. And you can see how you can't even see the little thread. So go ahead, finish sewing it on, and then come out the same place that you went in and tie your knot. So after you tie your knot, you can just cut your thread close to the knot. And then you're going to do the same thing on the other side. And
Before I finish mine, I'm just going to show you how to make the tail. So you're going to put another one on the other side and sew it on the same way. Now for the tail, you're just going to get your lace colored yarn, and we're going to start with a magic circle just like we did before. And we're going to do our slip knot, and then you're going to do 6 single crochet into the magic circle. And then you're going to close it the same way we did before. And now you're just going to do 1 single crochet into every stitch until you have the size that you want for your tail. So go ahead and do 1 single crochet into every stitch until you have the size that you want for your tail, and then come back and I'll show you how to sew it on. So for my tail, I did 1 single crochet for about 4 rows, then take your crochet hook, go into that next stitch over, then yarn over and bring your yarn through both loops on the hook for a slip stitch. Then you're going to yarn over and bring enough yarn through to sew the tail onto the dog. And you don't need to stuff the tail, I just put my loose yarn in into the center. And now you're just going to get your tapestry needle. And you're going to take your dog. And you're just going to see where you would like the tail to be. And then once you know where you would like the tail, make sure that your yarn end that you left for sewing is towards the back. And then you're just going to go in and grab a stitch on the back of the body where you want the tail. And then you're just going to sew the tail on and then bury your loose yarn in. So go ahead, sew your tail on and finish putting the hair onto the ears and the feet if you haven't done that already. And then come back and we'll see your finished dog. So this is how your dog should look right now. And from behind, you can see the tail sewn on. You can leave the hair curly like this on the dog, or you can kind of spread the yarn apart and make it a little bit more fuzzy to give it a little bit of a different look to your dog. Now I'm going to show you how to make the crochet collar and the name tag. So go ahead and get whatever color yarn you want to make your collar, and then you're just going to take, and we're going to do a slip knot. You're just going to fold it over on itself to form a loop, and I'm using my G crochet hook still, and hold the base of the loop with your middle finger and thumb, and then you're going to make a chain of 22, and I'm just going to show you 4 of them, but first let's finish the slip knot. Just bring your yarn through that loop for your slip knot, and now I'm going to show you how to make a chain, but I'm only going to do 4, and then you're going to go ahead and finish doing 22. So you just yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through the loop for 1, 2, 3, and 4. So go ahead and finish making a chain of 22, and then come back. After you make your chain of 22, go ahead and hold that last stitch you made with your middle finger and thumb, and you're going to do a chain 2. 1, 2, and that's going to count as your first half double crochet. Now we're going to do a half double crochet into the third chain from the hook, which is the stitch you're holding. Go ahead and yarn over, go into that third chain from the hook, bring up a loop, 3 loops on the hook, yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through all 3 for a half double crochet. And we're going to do a half double crochet into every stitch all the way back across. So I'm going to do 1 more with you, yarn over, go into the next stitch, bring up a loop, 3 loops on the hook, yarn over, and go through all 3 for a half double crochet. So go ahead and finish doing a half double crochet into every stitch back across. And this is how your work looks. Now we're going to go ahead and finish off. Just yarn over and pull enough yarn through the loop to tie the collar together. and just pull the knot down snugly. And then you're going to take your tapestry needle and put it on the loose yarn end. And then just decide which side you want to have showing on the dog. I'm going to do this side for mine. And then you just take your dog and put the collar on. Make sure it's not twisted. And then you just take and grab the first top stitch on the other side of the collar and pull the ends together. And then go through a second time so you can tie your knot. And then you're going to do the same thing with the bottom part. After you tie your knots on both the bottom and the top, just take your loose yarn ends and you're just going to take and just bury it. Just go through the work with the loose yarn end. And then take and cut the loose yarn ends. And then come back and I'll show you how to do the name tag. Now for the name tag, you're just going to do a magic circle. So just drape the yarn across your four fingers, use your thumb to stabilize, and then wrap the yarn around your two middle fingers twice. And you're going to do 6 single crochet into the magic circle. And then you're going to close it just like you did before. And then you're going to do 2 single crochet into every stitch around and then come back. So 2 single crochet into every stitch around until you finished a total of 12 and then come back. Now you can close the center of the magic circle if you like by turning it over and pulling on that loose yarn end. And now you're going to do a slip stitch. So go into the next stitch over and then you're going to yarn over and bring the yarn through both loops on the hook for a slip stitch. And then you're going to make a chain 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then you're going to finish off. Yarn over and just pull enough yarn through so you can tie a knot and bury the yarn, loose yarn end into your work. And now you're going to get your tapestry needle. And you're going to take the dog and just take your tapestry needle. Make sure your leash, your collar is not twisted. And then just take your tapestry needle and go behind your collar. And then make sure that your name tag is facing the way that you, the right side's facing you. And then you're going to take your tapestry needle through the top of the name tag. Make sure the hair doesn't get into your work. And just pull the chain so that the two sides meet. And then you can tie your knot. And you can do a double knot if you want. Just to make sure it's nice and secure. And then you can take and bury your loose yarn end by taking and weaving your tapestry needle through the back of the name tag. And then you just cut your loose yarn ends and then come back. And this is how your dog should be looking. And you can see her name tag.